Hello, I'm Mr. Anikarit. I lecture in mythology. I'm a scientist preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. So everything is here because this is the temple of God. Temple of God has the mine of His word. So you have to search it here, not outside. And searching here is called intuition or logical reasoning. So logical reasoning is the tool to find logo, which is His treasures. They are here, not in the books. Books can be altered. So here I'm going to tell you why Mary Magdalene, she had an egg which turned red. And the reason for it, this is the age of Christ. Christ is received by those who are living in Holy Spirit, not in the dead. The dead people, they are like vegetation or animals, you know, who cannot think or anything. So they are called once born, and once born people cannot think logically. They can go to universities to study the dead letters, which is scripture, by looking at the letters. That's why Jesus said, they see but not perceive. The perception comes to the mind of twice born people, and not in the mind of the once born people. If you tell them something you have perceived, they will laugh at you. And that's why Christ Jesus did not tell people in Israel that He is the Christ. But when He told to the Samaritan woman that He is the Christ, and there was no doubt in her mind that He is not the Christ. So, this is a simple illustration of seeing and perceiving. This is scripture, the dead letters. You can see. This is the top root of the tree of life, oral Torah, which you cannot see. But you have to perceive. So, among the Samaritans and Gentiles, they had this knowledge. And their tree was green. Whereas the Jewish people, because they were greedy, money-minded, so they have only the scripture, dead letters, but no knowledge of this oral Torah. That is why Jesus came to deliver. And when He was explaining the scripture in the synagogues, then He was explaining from the very root, top root of the scripture to the very details. That's what the Samaritan woman said. You look to be a prophet. But when Christ comes, He will tell us everything. So prophet and Christ, they are different. Prophets are witness to the light, like John the Baptist, but not the light. And the Christ is the very source of light. This is prophet, Elijah, and other, Moses, and everybody. Here is the Christ. Christ come in the dark age. This is the age of Christ. And Christ is received by those who are living in Holy Spirit, or who have sharp or discerning intelligence. Not among the dead in letters, dull people. Peter was once born. he could not understand the gospel. So the others were twice born. Judas Iscariot was greedy. He went for money, and he then fell down. So here is the Trinity which I have created. The university professors have no idea of this Trinity. Or if you go to them, they won't be able to tell. This is, you can make it your own Trinity like this. You develop it slowly. You don't get all this knowledge at once. You have to keep on struggling. That was St. Thomas said, keep on seeking until you find the very bottom root of the scripture or of your logo. So there are people of the world, the tribal people, salt of the earth, they go to learn scripture. There's a rabbi here teaching them the moral law. To be born of water. John the Baptist was prophet Elijah, ideal rabbi. So he created sons of man. He baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. He never baptized a woman, a Gentile or a Samaritan. So these are the once born people like Peter, Simon, who was once born. He could not understand gospel. Then by the grace of our supernatural father, you become twice born. When you are twice born, so these people are like vegetation. Vegetation like tree. Standing, you know, they can't move around. There are four type of living things, and the first one is this: anything born of the seed is called utpuj. Or these are the ones which are once born. They have strong instincts, but no thinking power or anything. So when they are get next stage is are born of egg. But you remember the parable of the sower? Some seeds fell on flat ground. Footpath, these are the footpath. They can't understand. The birds of the air came and picked them up. Birds of the air are here. People of spirit, Holy Spirit, twice born. They have discerning intellect, and they can use that intellect to earn the treasures of our supernatural father, or they can go for money, cheating people, making like the rich man at the door of which Lazarus was sitting. They can end here and into hell. And these people who are poor and they are seen to serve God, they don't cheat anyone. And they get here. Lazarus was here, friend of Jesus. And in him Jesus showed what is resurrection. So this is the twice born, and these people are like birds born of the egg. Anything born of the egg, you will find it has a strong sensory organs, very discerning intellect. So this is the age of this egg. People of egg, you know, discerning intellect, they will enjoy the gospel. This information is required before you can sift it out in here through logical reasoning. What is good you keep, the other one you throw it away, and this is the people who do it. Born of placenta, they have thinking power, and this one has strong sensory organs, like pigeon. If you let him off in Paris, he will come to London. And how he finds his way or anything, only God knows. So very strong sensory organs, snake, birds, anything born of egg has strong sensory organs. And these are the one which is, which have born of placenta. And they have sensory organs, but not as strong as this one. But they have, they can think, they can ponder. So fish have sensory organs like this one here. Very inquisitive. And here are the one who can ponder which logically. So these people who think logically, if they face, they are called wise men, Holy Ghost. This is Holy Son, Holy Father, if he doesn't cheat people, and Holy Ghost. And these people are the ones who are facing God. And their back is towards public, prophet, angel. That is what they do, they face God. Moses saw the face of God, he showed the back to the people, which is the scripture. So, this Trinity is the backbone of theology. So anybody who grasps it, understands it, he will understand gospel very easily. So you can see that these people which are born of egg, they have two choices. One to seek the praises of men, and then they speak, give sugar-coated sermons, as the politicians do. And those who seek the praises of our supernatural Father, they don't say that pleases the public, but what pleases our supernatural Father. So those people who turn their face to supernatural Father, they are solitary. And these people are not solitary, they want following. So here they be solitary, and then they enjoy the royal kingdom of God. And here is that one, the royal kingdom of God. Slowly and steadily I have created all these demonstrations. There is John the Baptist, angel, prophet Elijah, witness to the light but not the light, and he baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. And these people who are sons of man, tribal people, salt of the earth, they bury this ego of the seed. You remember the chosen people, they are very stiff-necked, egoistic, because they have the promised land. The chosen people are stiff-necked because Yahweh, who is the creator of this one, male and female, whatever you see with two naked eyes is the creation of Yahweh. The soul in us is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, which is supernatural. So all that nature that you see belongs to Yahweh, heaven, sun, moon, everything belongs to Yahweh. So, he is the one who is the Lord of the heaven, Lord of nature, Prophet Elijah. My God is Yahweh. He worships Yahweh. And our Christ Jesus, he worships Elohim Allah Parbrahm, the one who gives life to the people. Soul, father of our souls. So here the elite people who are very egoistic, they have to bury the ego of the tribal ego, that I'm a Judah tribe, Levi tribe. Some of them are very proud that our forefathers are priests and this and that. So they have to bury the ego. That's why St. Paul said, Don't put your seed on the mental peace. Mental peace and keep on praising that my forefather was so and so, so and so. Bury the ego. And as you bury a seed in the soil, it turns in, comes out as a plant. And that plant is the one which is called twice born. That will bear fruit and not seed. So those who turn the seed into plant, they enter this royal vineyard where your soul is concerned, not your physical body or material world. That's why Jesus said, when you go into this royal kingdom of God, don't take any money in your pocket. That's why this is the Sabbath theme, the middle candle of menorah. So that's why Jesus said, don't take any money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tulips, and no script. Bible is forbidden here. So this is the word of sadhus, Melchizedek. While you are sitting at home, you can enjoy that one. Whilst in the other ages, you have to leave your home and go for wilderness to enjoy the solitude of our royal kingdom. So this is for the solitary, and which are twice more. Here your soul is concerned, and soul is valued by the merciful deeds, because your heart is concerned here, not your physical body. So here your physical body is concerned. People are Levi tribe, Judah tribe, so and so. Each one has its own father. Own father, what apply to flesh? The opposite apply to spirit. And here we have one father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, and we are all his sons. So those who are living in Holy Spirit, and Holy Spirit is by the grace of our supernatural father. And those who get this grace, and they can use it to earn the treasures of our supernatural father, or they can teach people to make money. They become big politicians with big following, like Tony Blair and Bush, chief minister and the president. They both told blasphemy when they said Saddam Hussein had weapon of mass destruction. There were none over there. And you can see people are speaking out that there were none, no weapon of mass destruction there. On a lame excuse they destroy it because they were governed by the Jewish people in America, Mammon and media. And they governed them. So there's a politician in Britain, Green Party, and that is what she drew a cartoon that this Jewish man putting an American flag, that means Jews in America, Mammon and media, which is enemy of God. That's why Jesus said, don't put any money in your pocket. And here they are full of money. And holding sickle, which is devil's cross. And they are causing all this bloodshed one after the other. That is the evil use of the thing. They are saltless people. And they are due of physical appearance, not inwardly, but outwardly. And Jesus called them in John 8, verse 44, that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. And they retorted that we are born of legitimate parents. But Jesus said, when you become Jew outwardly, then you break your covenant with Abraham, a noble man. That was Angel Stephen stressed in the Sanhedrin, that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham by circumcising the Gentile. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the seed of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. But you see today, these people, Iranian and other people, when the Jewish people enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, over there, they initiated all those temple practices. kosher is called halal, and God or Elohim has no son. That's why Jesus, when he said he is the Messiah in the temple, then the temple priest said, now you call yourself God, because son represents father, and now we must kill you. So same thing was done by mullahs. They killed those people who proclaimed that they are the Christ, or they are the sons of the Most High, Allah, Parbrahm. And they created atrocities. So that is what's happening now. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled, and people are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. They are chosen people where the Yahweh brings Abram from the Iraq area, a nobleman, to settle in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and they were given promised land as Garden of Eden. And they were living in the company of Yahweh. And there were plenty, the land was plentiful. Garden of Eden, you can well imagine how it would be. No, plenty to eat and everything. Blessing of Yahweh were there. And when Jacob had 12 sons, and 11 they were crook, and Joseph was honest. He was telling the truth to Jacob, and the other were jealous of him. And so they sold Joseph as a slave to the Egyptian. As soon as he left the promised land, there were none who was faithful to Brahm or to Yahweh. So Yahweh stopped rain. And Abraham had no concern for them, because they were not faithful to him. They don't want to know it. Abraham doesn't want to know it. So they kicked them out. And they went to Egypt as a slave. And over there they suffered. And Moses brought them back. Faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, the same land became lush green. Where was this climate change and all that thing which they are talking about? These are all the punishment of Yahweh for killing innocent men in the Middle East, in Iraq, Libya, other things. What wrong they have done? Because of the Jewish people in America, who are saltless people, they are against humanity. They are enemy of humanity. Mammon and media, bombs and all that they make, you know. So, end time is there. Atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. From 2018, when Israel was 70 years old, we have 5 years of grace. 5 husbands of the Samaritan woman. 5 years of grace, and then we will be atomic bomb. Much more I can tell, but there are no customers. People don't want to know this Trinity or anything. They just read the Bible. I have done. Then they say prayer. Our Father in heaven. Is our Father in heaven or in here? He lived in his temple. He haven't deserted his temple. If your heart is clean. But if you are greedy, mammon worshipper, cheating people, Satan in it, God is out. So then he is in heaven. So those who have God inside them and their temple is clean, they know where the God is. They don't say prayer or fasting. So our Father is no more in heaven. He is no more alienated. He is here. And it is for those who are twice born, sealed to serve God, not mammon. Not seeking the praises of men, but they are solitary, entering the royal kingdom of God, enjoying the company of Christ Jesus. I am the younger brother of Christ Jesus. I preach Christianity. I'm not a Christian. I'm a Christ. Christ with small c, with Holy Spirit with small s. Christ Jesus has Holy Spirit with capital S. And capital S Spirit you get by the grace of our supernatural Father as a reward, as they got it at Pentecost. That was their reward by our supernatural Father. And they were blessed with Holy Spirit with capital S. And Peter was who was once born. He enjoyed it very much. He was the one who was start preaching gospel and feeling drunk with the new wine. And so many things you can learn. All these things are in here. You can learn intuition. If you are not capable of intuition, you can't get gospel. Intuition is logical reasoning. If you do logical reasoning, everything is here. Nobody is going to do it for you. That's why St. Paul said, gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart here. The scripture ended with John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. So afterward, no more scripture, but it is time of Holy Spirit, no more sin, but blasphemy. As Tony Blair and Bush blasphemy that Saddam was a weapon of mass destruction, and they killed many people under the name of excuse. You think Yahweh is sitting idle? No. It is the Yahweh who has brought this coronavirus and other things he will bring. You will see a lot of disasters taking place in the country which bombed them, especially America. America, Britain, and Poland and other countries which took part in the killing of the innocent people in Iraq, Libya, and other countries. And Syria, they are the people of salt, Russian. They have tribal instinct. They are supporting the Syrian president, elected one. And America supporting the rebels against humanity. That is what you expect, you know, of the saltless people. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape. Agape is unconditional divine love, because the rain falls on the good as well on the evil alike. So in God we hate none. And our Father blesses everyone.